Craig scrambling again from Rafter. This stage, Goran has just got to stay calm and play percentage tough tennis. No more of these drop volleys or crazy shots that he's been throwing in.
Well, it's all there for the taking. Neither man has won this title before. They both want it desperately. Marvellous touch here.
15.
Yes, just a little bit lucky perhaps that it clipped the top of the net and didn't fly out, but he was playing for that angle.
Getting that second serve up high, making it difficult to pull down. It's got some pace on it as well.
Rafter leads by 2 games to 1, final sets.
Well, at this stage of a final set at the greatest championship in the world, it's all about control of the emotions that are surging through you with so much at stake. The question is, which will survive?
Well, you know, you do wonder that, and I basically, I think that the more stable guy who's played the more tennis and has been playing well in the last year or so, which is Rafter. I mean, I just... famous last words, but I can't see that the continuous pressure from Rafter, how Ivanisevic is not at some stage going to snap.
Do you think also that Goran, I mean, in the back of his mind, he's lost 3 finals, and now he's thinking, oh, my God, if there's any doubt enters his head at this stage of the match, then he's gone. And Rafter, you know, in the finals last year against Sampras, admittedly did choke a little bit in that second set tiebreaker. So both of them are in a position where they could certainly choke, let's face it.
Yeah, I don't think Rafter's going to do it this year, though. He's had a year more experience under his belt.
So once again, playing catch-up Ivanisevic. Which is why that advantage of the first serve in the fifth set, it gets tighter and tighter, is so important.
Love. what you love.
Well said.
Well, it's amazing to think that we walked, you and I, Lordy, talked at the beginning of this match. He said, oh, there's going to be a couple of tiebreakers and there's only going to be a few points in it, but we haven't had one yet.
We haven't even got close to a tiebreaker yet. I mean, it's amazing. Well, maybe they're saving it for the last. I mean, there's no tiebreaker, of course, in the fifth, but maybe we'll get a 10-8 in the fifth. Who knows?
Goran's having a few problems with the returns at the moment.
Thank you.
Did I speak?
Well, that's the trouble. Every now and again, he finds one.
That's also the danger. It's if he doesn't make a return for, say, two games and then puts two or three together, it's like Raft is cold. He hasn't hit a tough volley for a while.
Well, it's gone exactly as we thought it would in terms of the serve being absolutely dominant and the ability of both players to find that one moment of magic or skill or luck to turn the match their way with service returns. But what a knife edge to run along.
Let's have a look at the first serves. This is crucial for these guys. Goran having a dip in the second set, picking out winning the third set. And then Rafter, look at that, 82% in that fourth set. And that's almost impossible to break serve with a guy who can volley as well as he has.
Well, let's just listen to this crowd and their reaction now. And that 20th ace brings him level with his previous record of 206 here.
Love.
Cortula. Net, first service.
Well, neither player having a problem holding serve at the moment.
With
three games all, we're getting close to the business end of the championship, to say the least, the business end. Every point absolutely crucial.
After a modest 11, now he's served 90 here.
I mean, talk about dangerous. I mean, how do you know when the guy's going to hit a clean winner like that?
59. Net, first service.
Rafter leads by 4-3, final set. And of course, Rafter, with the advantage of 2 days off, even if he's had none, showing no signs of any of the physical frailty which has affected him in 5-set matches already this year in Davis Cup and against Agassi in the Australian Championships.
Well, yeah, those days were pretty extreme weather and conditions. I mean, shortly, these are unusual conditions as far as tension is concerned, but they were very, very hot days. I mean, today is, I suppose, it's just about an ideal day for a tough 5-set match. You know, it's cool and it's overcast and there's no wind. You know, Pat's not going to... And he's had 2 days off, of course. Well, that's the other thing. And Goran, of course, on the other hand, hasn't had a day off and has had an unbelievable tension yesterday, even though it was only a matter of 4 or 5 games. It's a matter of the tension culminating and whether Goran can handle it here at this part of the match. Been throwing in.
What are your final sets?
Well, it's all there for the taking. Neither man has won this title before. They both want it desperately.
Team love. Team love.
getting that second serve up high, making it difficult to pull down. It's got some pace on it as well.
Marvellous touch here. 15. Yes, just a little bit lucky perhaps that it took the top of the net and didn't fly out, but he was playing for that angle.
Great scrambling again from Rafter. The stage Goran has just got to stay calm and play percentage tough tennis. No more of these drop volleys or crazy shots that he's been